Looking forward to the film, first of all.
Very much, yeah.
Why are you looking forward to the film? What excited you about this one?
I grew up through that age of rebellion. I mean, I think it's just a fantastic idea of militant, you know, men who do physical labour who aren't known for their sympathy or empathy with homosexuals, but joining together against an establishment. I think it's a truly inspiring idea.
What are you personally hoping for, looking to the future for Sherlock?
Well, what I like about Sherlock is, I love it when the scripts come. I mean, I get as delighted as any. I think I have the excitement when I read the script that people do when they see it. So I just want a kind of great story that's going to lead us through our noses and delight us and amaze us and make us gasp and wanting more.
Of course, I mean, audience have just been captivated by this chemistry, I think, particularly between Benedict and Martin. Can you talk a little bit about working with the pair of them and what you think makes their bond on screen so very special?
I think they're very different. I think, you know, Benedict's kind of very, very hyper and as you can see when he just when he puts on the show. They're not, you know, I'm not saying they're their characters, but they interpret the characters in the style of their own personalities. I think it's quite a good measure of them. I think it's a really fantastic piece of casting, putting those two together. It just works, because they're not the same, but they blend perfectly.
Andrew is a big star in this film. You've obviously worked with him before. What makes him such a special talent, and how excited are you to potentially have him back?
I have no idea what's going to happen. He's kind of one of those wonderful, fearless actors who just does... The muse comes upon him and he goes with it and he's not frightened and he doesn't contain himself and I think that's a beautiful thing to watch.
What's been your most fond memory of playing Greg so far?
I don't know, Greg makes me laugh because he's always kind of comes in a bit late and asks a question and puzzles it and then... what I like is that, you know, because it started off as a bit of a dim copper, I think there's a nice relationship between with Sherlock and him. He's very fond of him. Sherlock pisses him off, but he's very fond of him. He can't live without him. He champions him. He kind of loves him, and he's jealous of him. And I like all those contradictions.
There's rumours we might be getting Tom Hiddleston as a third Sherlock Holmes brother. Would you be excited to work with him? Do you think he'd be a good addition to the...
I've already worked with him, so I think he's a great actor, yeah. But I haven't heard those rumours, but...